Hello students, welcome to the session. Again, there is a continuation of the granulomatous inflammation that we are talking about leprosy. So earlier we spoke about tuberculoid leprosy. Now lepromatous leprosy. The morphology of the lepromatous leprosy. This involves the skin, peripheral nerves, anterior chamber of the eye, upper airways, down to the larynx, testes, hands and feet. The vital organs and central nervous system are rarely affected, but the core temperature varies. Lepromatous lesions contain large aggregates of lipid-laden macrophages. They are called as lepra cells, often filled with masses, that is globi or acid-fast bacilli. Because of the abundant bacteria, lepromatous leprosy is referred to as multibacillary, macular, papular or nodular lesions form on the face, ears, wrist, elbows and knees. With progression, the nodular lesions coalesce to yield a distinctive linolin facies. Most skin lesions are hypoesthetic or anesthetic. Loss of sensation. Lesions in the nose may cause persistent inflammation and bacilli-laden discharge. The peripheral nerves, particularly the ulnar and peroneal nerves where they approach the skin surface, are symmetrically invaded with mycobacteria with minimal inflammation. Loss of sensation and tropic changes in the hands and feet follow the nerve lesions. Lymph nodes contain aggregates of bacteria-filled foamy macrophages in the paracortical areas and reactive germinal centers. Next, there is one more condition called as syphilis. This is also one of the granulomatous inflammation. Syphilis is a venereal sexual transmitted disease caused by spirochetes, Tropenema pallidum, with multiple clinical presentations. The word syphilis is derived from the name of the mythological handsome boy Syphilus, who was cursed by Greek god Apollo with the disease. Spirochetes are gram-negative, slender, corkscrew-shaped bacteria with axial periplasmic flagella wound around a helical protoplasma. They have an outer sheath which may mask bacterial antigens from the host immune response. Mode of transmission: sexual intercourse resulting in lesions on glans penis, vulva, vagina and cervix. Intimate person-to-person contact with lesions on lips, tongue or fingers. Transfusion of infected blood or materno-fetal transmission in congenital syphilis if the mother is infected. There are different stages of syphilis, especially the stages of acquired syphilis: primary syphilis, secondary syphilis and tertiary syphilis. Primary syphilis, typical lesion is chancre, which appears on genitals or at extragenital sites in 2 to 4 weeks after exposure to infection. Initially, the lesion is a painless papule which ulcerates in the center, so that the fully developed chancre is an indurated lesion with central ulceration accompanied by regional lymphadenitis. The chancre heals without scarring even in the absence of treatment. Morphology: in primary syphilis, a chancre occurs on the penis or scrotum of 70% of men and on the vulva or cervix of 50% of women. The chancre is a slightly elevated, firm, reddened papule up to several centimeters in diameter. The erodes to create a clean-based shallow ulcer. The contagious induration creates a button-like mass directly adjacent to the eroded skin, providing the basis for the designation or chancre. On histological examination, treponemas are visible at the surface of the ulcer with silver stains. The chancre contains an intense infiltrate of plasma cells with scattered macrophages and lymphocytes and a proliferative endocarditis, which is seen in all stages of syphilis, starts with endothelial cells activation and proliferation and progresses to intimal fibrosis. The regional nodes are usually enlarged due to non-specific acute or chronic lymphadenitis. Plasma cells rich in infiltrates are granulomas. Secondary syphilis. Inadequately treated patients of primary syphilis develop mucocutaneous lesions and painless lymphadenopathy in 2 to 3 months after the exposure. Mucocutaneous lesions may be in the form of the mucus patches on mouth, pharynx and vagina, and generalized skin eruption and condyloma lata in anogenital region. Antibody tests are always positive and highly infective stage. In secondary syphilis, widespread mucocutaneous lesions involve the oral cavity, palms of the hands and soles of the feet. The rash frequently consists of discrete red-brown macules less than 5 mm in diameter, but it may be follicular, pistular, annular or scaly. Red lesions in the mouth or vagina contain the most organisms and are the most infectious. Histologically, the mucocutaneous lesions of secondary syphilis show the same plasma cell infiltrate and obliterative endocarditis as the primary chancre, although the inflammation is often less intensive. The final stage, that is the tertiary syphilis, after a latent period of appearance of secondary lesions and about 2 to 3 years following the first exposure, lesions are much less infective than the other two stages, and spirochetes can be demonstrated with great difficulty. There is a condition called as syphilitic gamma. It is a solitary localized rubbery lesions with central necrosis seen in organs like liver, testes, bone and brain. In liver, the gamma is associated with scarring of hepatic parenchyma, that is called upper lobatum. Histologically, the structure of gamma shows central coagulative necrosis resembling caseous, but it is less destructive, so that outlines of necrosed cells can still be faintly seen. Surrounding zone of palisaded macrophages with many plasma cells, some lymphocytes, giant cells and fibroblasts. There is one more condition called as cardiovascular syphilis, mainly involves thoracic aorta. The wall of the aorta is weakened and dilated due to syphilitic aortitis. And neurosyphilis may manifest as meningovascular syphilis, congenital syphilis, that is a saddle-shaped nose deformity due to destruction of bridge of the nose, that is called as Hutchinson's teeth, which are small, widely spaced, peg-shaped permanent teeth, bony lesions like epiphysetis and periostitis. Thank you.